We'll move towards the next lecture. The speaker is very much available, and he is also a legendary person in the field of animal science, in the field of livestock product technology. And here, I would like to introduce him, Dr. Girish Patil, sir. Dr. Girish Patil, sir, you are requested to please open your video.
Yeah, good evening all.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, good evening.
Very good evening and welcome to this training program. So before you start your before I request you to start your lecture, I would like to introduce you to the audience. One second, sir, please. So, dear friends, we are in the third lecture of our today's training program. And today's our third lecture's eminent speaker is Dr. S. Girish Patil, sir. He is the principal scientist, ICAR NRC Meet on Hyderabad. And sir will be talking with us on topic portable meat production. PMART technology. So what is that PMART? So he'll be letting us know about through his lecture. Before that, I would like to introduce him in nutshell. Sir is Master in Veterinary Science and PhD from ICAR, Indian Veterinary Research Institute, Bareilly. Sir is a recipient of many awards, including Junior Research Fellowship for MBSC, ICAR Senior Research Fellowship, and PhD Studies. Sir has ran six externally funded research projects, including DBT, ICAR, Information Technology Research Academy, so which is from the Ministry of Food Processing and Food Processing Industry. And also from he has run one project from Northeast Council and World Bank. So sir has run six mega projects, and his frontier areas of research are meat species identification, then meat traceability, application of information technology for safe meat production, organic meat production, and lab-grown meat production. He has undergone two international trainings, techniques developed by him for species identification of the meat using molecular techniques are being used in the different forensic laboratories of the country. So it is his great contribution. Sir has published more than 60 research papers in national and international journals with more than 1,000 citations and published. And sir has published five books. He has organized more than 50 events, including trainings, workshops, expos, exhibitions, and conferences for imparting scientific knowledge to the different stakeholders of meat production. He has worked as an expert member in the committees of Food Safety and Standards Authority of India, that is FSSAI, also Bureau of Indian Standards, that is BIS, we do say, and Agriculture and Processed Food Products Export Development Authority, APEDA. Sir is regularly providing consultancy services and involved in technology transfer programs for promoting entrepreneurship in the meat sector. So this was the sir's introduction, and here are some awards which I have already spoken about. So welcome you, sir. Welcome you, sir, and I would like to welcome you from the organizer side, from the participant side, and this would be the great session, one of the great sessions to listen you. So I request you, sir, to kindly continue your lecture, please.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Just I want to know what is the background of the participants.
Sir, yeah. Participants here, they are academicians, researchers, field veterinarians, and some of the entrepreneurs also.
Okay.
So it is a one of the mixed groups. So where everybody would like to listen.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. So very happy to know this is a very different training program wherein we are doing it in the evening time. I know one of the first programs I attended in the evening programs. So good development. Is my presentation visible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Your presentation is fine.
Okay. So today for all the participants, very good evening. I am going to present a very novel portable meat production retailing facility. Actually, now in sheep and goat sector, the most important thing is final post-harvest processing. That's where we are lacking at present in India. We have the production, but where do we slaughter the animals and how do we market? So that is the question. And large slaughterhouses which are located in center of the city, very difficult to carry the animals. And also that can be done for huge number of animals, but what will a small scale meat producer will do? Maybe somebody is slaughtering 5 animals and 10 animals. How will he do the slaughter? To address this issue, we have developed a novel technology, portable meat production retailing facility, a novel facility for hygienic meat production from sheep and goats. Now, I'm from ICR, National Research Center on Meat, Hyderabad. So ours is the only institute in India working exclusively on meat and meat products. Okay, so we work on all aspects of meat, starting from the production, meat animal production, meat production, value addition to meat, and then say quality and safety assurance, meat species identification, all aspects of the meat. And we also organize training programs in meat processing, okay, and value addition. So now, the people are from different sector, just I want to introduce regarding the Indian meat sector. In India, around 71% of the human population, they are non-vegetarian. Meat contributes immensely for the animal protein consumption in the country. Actually, animal protein is very important because bioavailability of protein will be very high in animals, in the animal products. Okay, so whether it is milk or meat, bioavailability will be very high. So with increasing income, demand for the meat and meat products also rises. It has been seen across the world. So meat group contributes around 2,18,000 crores to the national GDP. So meat production is growing at around 7% per annum. And meat production in India has doubled in the last 10 years with rapid growth in the per capita income. Okay. So in the last 10 years, the demand for the meat also has risen. So it was around 8.1 million ton in 2019-20. In the year 2019-20, India exported around 1.15 million tons worth of buffalo meat worth around $3,175 million. That comes around 23,000 crore rupees. So India stands fifth in the world meat production, around 3% of the world meat production. Now, if you see state-wise, the states which you are seeing in the pink, they are majorly meat-consuming states. Means the majority of the population are consuming meat. So highest meat consumption in India happens in Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. So wherein around more than 98% of the population, they consume the meat. The states which are shown in green, like Rajasthan, Gujarat, and part of Maharashtra, here the majority of the people are vegetarians. Okay. So now this program in Maharashtra, what you're doing here, in this Maharashtra, around 40% of the people are vegetarians and 60% are non-vegetarians. If you see the species-wise contribution of meat, around half of the total meat produced is contributed by poultry, that is chicken. The contribution of poultry is rising rapidly. And goat contributes around 13.5%. Sheep contributes 8% to the total meat production. 20% is buffalo. But out of this 20% buffalo meat, which comes around 1.5 million tons, 80% of the meat is exported. The cattle is around 4% and pig is around 5%. So this is the contribution of the meat. Now, meat production. if you want to achieve hygienic meat production, what are the important requirements? First thing is we should have the infrastructure. We should have a proper facility for the slaughter and practices. We should follow hygienic meat production practices and personnel should be well trained. Now for the infrastructure, we have to follow Bureau of Indian Standards. Which standards are there? BIS 4393, which was revised in 2016. So these are all freely downloadable. You can see it. That is the infrastructure one has to follow. And then practices, we have to follow Food Safety and Standards Authority of India, Part 4, Schedule 4. So there how the meat production has to be done, everything is mentioned. And personnel, you have to get it trained. Okay. So now, if you follow the Bureau of Indian Standards, this slaughterhouse pattern, minimum requirement for establishing a slaughterhouse is around 1.5 to 2 crores. So minimum, it goes to 1 crores. Now, in that context, so can we make a simple meat production unit? In that direction, we did our research. So infrastructure is the key for the hygienic meat production. And then India has around 4,000 registered and around more than 25,000 unregistered slaughterhouses as per the FSSA records. And creating infrastructure for small scale operations is a challenge. So now PMART is designed to fill this gap. So now you know the problem of slaughterhouses everywhere. CPPCB, Central Pollution Control Board, says India slaughterhouses need to upgrade to the check pollution. Illegal slaughterhouses flourish in the city. Meat sellers in India strike, commit clampdown on illegal slaughterhouses. So all this, there are many problems in the meat production sector. And now there is one CPPCB, Central Pollution Control Board report is there. This report was released in 2017. So this report was prepared in collaboration with ILRI, Indian Leather Research Institute. Now this report says, so there is a local municipal authorities and no effort has been made to make the meat production an important economic activity. There's a lack of awareness, poor private participation, environmental problems are some of the constraints in providing the hygienic meat and meat products. The effluents and solid waste generated from the slaughterhouse are disposed without proper treatment. Solid waste is disposed along with the municipal solid waste in open dumping in most of the cities and towns. Few slaughterhouses operated by the municipal corporations have established treatment plants and some have also engaged services of private companies for operation and maintenance of the mechanized slaughterhouses. Now, regarding the status of slaughterhouses, it says there are around 1,176 slaughterhouses and 75 modern abattoir complex. As most of the slaughterhouses are operated and managed by municipalities, investment for improvement of infrastructure for slaughterhouses is difficult, it says. Slaughterhouses in rural areas are under the control of local bodies like panchayats. Slaughterhouses maintained by them get least priority as they have limited resources for this activity and hence no standard practices are followed. Production of meat from these slaughterhouses is consumed by domestic retail market, cannot be recognized as a meat from organized sector. So that is what in most of the places expect, except in the metro cities or some of the district places, wherein to say some slaughter places are there, some slaughterhouses are there. Otherwise, most of the places, they're all done in the unregistered slaughter places. And it also says that while in the modern slaughterhouses, it will be difficult for them to get now. Central and state governments in the past have been effective in improving the basic infrastructure like building, lighting, water supply, drainage arrangement, etc. But some of the slaughterhouses which require relocation and the scheme have not been effective, mainly since the trader resisted the centralized process of slaughterhouses. You go and ask any of the slaughter infrastructure project anywhere, including in the Hyderabad also we have seen. First thing is local butcher community, they will resist it. In the existing system, small and medium traders bring their own animals for slaughter and they take back the meat and all the byproducts with them. Okay. When here, what happens? They 5 to 10 animals they slaughter along with the carcass, they carry the byproducts also. While in the modern slaughterhouses, it will be difficult for them to get all the byproducts. You must have seen the online overhead drive slaughterhouses. So there, it is very difficult to collect their byproducts, which corresponds to their animals. Distance to be traveled may be very longer. Now in Hyderabad, they constructed a slaughterhouse in Chengicherla, way back around 25 years before, okay, by putting around 35 crores worth of investment in that period. And that was far off from the city. It's very difficult for the meat community people to carry the animals and carry back the meat. That is why most of the times it was not used. So now we'll pay increased slaughtering fee. There will be no control over the method of slaughtering like halal and jitka, etc. The concerns. The number of animals brought by each trader varies from 1 to 15. Therefore, centralized slaughtering became difficult and inconvenient for small traders. Many slaughterers which have been upgraded are not used properly to its full capacity or not operational. The Ministry of Food Processing has a scheme to support the large model slaughterhouses for supply of meat to domestic and meat exports. Therefore, all the stakeholders should be informed. So I am showing it from the report itself, because you also, whomsoever is involved in the meat sector, they know what is happening in the slaughterhouses, how much it is used. Okay. And like this, it goes on, and then I will not go into further details. And it says slaughterhouses are being leased where hygienic meat processing procedure and environment here. To give some examples, in Hyderabad city itself, initially it was in Chengicherla. It was far off from the city. Then meat handlers told it is far off, you make something in the city. And within the city they made. So there also overhead rails they could not use. Now we have 5 slaughterhouses. In all the 5 slaughterhouses, slaughter is done in the lairage only. Overhead rails are being left as it is. So that is the very bad image. So large number of slaughterhouses are very old and operate with inadequate basic amenities. Okay, all those things. So now classification of slaughterhouses based on type of process. They are now 95% of the slaughter happening in India are manual. Okay, semi-mechanized is only 4% and mechanized is 1%. And now, so to solve this, to provide a solution for the meat producers who undertake meat production from 5 to 10 animals, or that is the small scale meat producers, we provided a solution. For this purpose, we conceptualized the P-Mart, that is P-Mart is Portable Meat Production and Retailing Unit. It was developed by NRCN Meat and it has been patented by NRCN Meat. Okay. Now the basic facilities for the here, what we have considered is basic facilities for hygienic meat production, disposal of waste, meat handlers comfort, prevalent production and retailing practices, animal welfare and durability. These things were considered. And designing and preparation of the outline and drawing we have done is fabrication of the unit. The unit was fabricated with the reputed fabricator in Hyderabad and it was validated by slaughtering the good number of animals. So this is the drawing wherein, as you can see, there are 4 different units are there. All 4 units are wheeled. Now it has totally around 51 different parts. For each of these accessories, 51 accessories and the main part, we were to do a lot of research. We worked in detail and we have come into this model. So this is a photograph you can see. Now, as you can see here, there are 4 units. The first one, unit 1, is lairage. Second unit is stunning and slaughtering and postmortem inspection area. Third one is meat packaging, cutting and packaging. Fourth one is retailing. So P-Mart is facility for small scale operations up to 10 sheep per goat per day only. The facility comprises 4 units. All 4 units are wheeled and can be moved independently. That is a good thing about this. Now it's not difficult. If you want to take it on the vehicle, you can carry it. If you want, you can operate it on the ground. If you want to make it as a mobile slaughterhouse, if you want to put it on the vehicle and run, you can run it also. So it can be operated both on the vehicle and on the ground. So as you can see here, it can be put in a vehicle which is having a length of around 17 feet, around 6 feet width. You can put it. Facility can be operated on a vehicle or on the ground. Now, the width of this unit is 4 feet. Okay. Each unit, as I told, there are 4 units. Each unit is length and width of 4 feet by 4 feet. Okay. That is the thing of the measurement of this unit. Now, first part. Unit 1 is lairage. So lairage is the resting space. As per the standard meat production practices, when the animals are brought to the slaughterhouse, they come from the long distance. So they need to be rested prior to the slaughter. Apart from resting, around 12 hours before slaughter, they should be offed. No feed should be given and only water should be provided. Okay. Now, when the animals are kept in the lairage, feed is removed, only water is provided. We have provided the facility for recording the temperature through infrared IRT camera, and then proper lighting is provided, water storage is provided, water can offer 20 liter capacity, tray for collection of the droppings. When the animals are standing there, the droppings will be there. We have the trays. So these trays can be removed and it can be done. Antemortem examination of the animals can also be done here. Now, as you can see here, unit one, Lyrate, there are two floors are there. Each floor can carry five animals. So 10 animals can be rested in this Lyrate unit. If you are putting in the vehicle, you can put it, you can put the animals inside. If you are doing a ground operation, it is not mandatory to put the animals inside this unit. You can put it outside also. So whenever you are taking it or traveling, or if you want to protect the animals in the night time and all, you can put it inside. So this Lyrate can hold 10 animals. So what are the different accessories present? Now, as I told, trays for collection of the droppings, stainless steel buckets, infrared thermometer, and then scoop for removing the droppings, sponge for cleaning, electric power points, and stainless steel cans. In the second unit, that is the slaughtering and stunning unit. So here, there's a provision for electrical stunning. So bleeding of the animal is done here. Gambrel for hanging and dressing. Now, the first basic principle of hygienic meat production is the dressing has to be done away from the floor. For that purpose, a gambrel has been provided. The gambrel is hung onto the roof so that the carcass can be hung and proper skinning and evisceration can be done. Now, cutting of the carcass can be done here. There is a provision for water storage. Okay, collection. Then also water for drinking water for the operator is also provided here. Collection of the GAT content. Now in the live animal, around in an animal, in sheep and goat, around 17 to 20% of the live weight is constituted by GAT content, gastrointestinal tract content. So we have provided special provision for collection of the GAT content in a tank. So there is a hanging balance, water spray for cleaning the carcass. So now if you put the pipe in the water, if you clean the premises or the carcass with the piped water, you will be wasting a lot of water. Apart from wasting water, that water becomes very difficult to treat also. That is why we have provided a special sprayer so that use of the water is used optimum way without much wastage. Okay, so minimal water. So in that way, the whole process has been standardized. And then LPG gas cylinder with burner has been provided for singeing. Trays for collection of the blood and wash water and post-mortem examination. As you can see here, the carcass is hung. Proper de-skinning can be done. And in the ground part, all the different storage things are there. Okay. Now let us see what are the different accessories. First thing is LPG singeing. So why this is provided? After the slaughter, once the head is cut and legs are cut, generally what they are doing, they are burning it by burning it in a coal, okay, by the, so that also creates a lot of pollution. So here using this LPG sink, the head and the leg part of the sheep and goat can be burned properly. And then we have the nylon frame. On this nylon frame, we can put the carcass and it can be cut. Stainless steel trays. So these removable trays have been provided wherein when we are doing the bleeding. So blood during the bleeding is collected in this tray. And it is without putting it in the drainage, it is properly collected. Okay. And then after bleeding is done, we put another tray wherein wastewater is collected. The wastewater, whatever is collected, is put into the tank or can wherein this wastewater collection can is provided. You can see the water sprayers, steel buckets, gambrels, hanging balance. Okay. Electrical stunner. We have specially designed electrical stunner. If you buy electrical stunner in the market, they go from 1.5 to 2 lakh. Now we have made a very simple stunner so that it serves the purpose of small scale slaughtering. Then dongas for taking the water, hand wash powder for container. If you use the soap and all, it creates a lot of pollution. That is why we have created, we are giving some special powders which are made from the household items which can be used for washing of the hand. So that will create minimum pollution actually. The knife holders are there. Complete knife set is provided. Knife set, blades and the scissors are provided. And the insect cutters is provided so that there is no flies, a problem of the flies and the insects. Knife sharpening stone is provided, knife sharpening rod, sponges, wall mounted fan for the comfort of the operators, electric power points, exhaust fan and drinking water bottle for the operator. So these are all the different accessories present in the unit 2. So here, as you can see here, there is electrical stunning is done here. And then after that, we de-skin it. And then GIT solid waste collection. There is a special can provided for the collection of the solid waste. And then e-visceration. And you can see here singeing of the head and neck, how it is done. So then head and neck can also be sold from there only. Then coming to the fourth part. So this is the dressing and cutting and packaging. That is the unit three. Unit three is cutting and packaging. So here for proper cutting, rotary bone cutter is provided. So if you go for the band saw commercially available, it will be very costly and it will not be required for a small scale operation. So we have used the rotary bone cutter. So generally available rotary cutters they are using for the cutting of the bone. Deboning, tubing, weighing and packaging, hanging and the platform balances. Now as you can see here, nylon board is provided. So now if you use the wooden logs and other things, it also becomes a source of contamination. So nylon board is provided for clean operation and specially fabricated bone holder is prepared. Okay. Then storage and collection of the bones, steel tray for collection of the liquid waste, meat mincer is provided here because some people ask for the minced meat. They call it a schema. For that meat mincer is provided. Steel boxes are provided for the packaging of meat. Now polythene is also a pollution creator. That is why we have provided steel boxes. So here each box will hold around 500 gram of meat. So here we can use these boxes for the packing of the meat also and byproduct also. Now idea here is, so these meat boxes, either consumer, whenever he comes here, he can have his container and take this meat. Otherwise he can carry the box, put a deposit, and whenever he comes next time, he can bring back the box. So to give you more detail of different accessories, this is the bone holding forceps for cutting the bone. This is the rotary bone cutter. Bone holder, this is a specially designed so that the long bones can be properly fixed and it can be cut. Gambrel for hanging of the carcass. Hanging balance for weighing of the carcass. Complete knife set. One set of knives are provided in unit 2, another set is provided in unit 3. Knife holder, then meat mincer, steel containers, water sprayers, steel trays and nylon board. Nylon board for hygienic cutting operations. And then we have platform balance. So platform balance so that whatever the meat we are packing, it can be weighed. We have provided the standard weight so that we can calibrate the equipment, and then steel boxes for packing of the meat, hand wash powders. As I told earlier also, we are providing some organic powder, electric switchboards, wall mounted fans, exhaust fans, insect cutters, knife sharpening stone, knife sharpening rod, water bottle. All these things, one set is given in unit 2 also, unit 3 also, so that without any contamination, it can be done. And then aprons. Aprons are two sets of aprons. Now this unit can be run from by two persons. That is why two sets of aprons are provided. Coming to the last unit, that is the retailing unit. Here, this unit comfortably two persons can sit. Okay, now whole operation can be done by two persons. Now there is a clean operation and unclean operation. Unit 1 and unit 2 are unclean operation. Unit 3 and 4 are clean operations. Therefore, there should not be any mix up. So accordingly, two persons can operate. Okay. Now in this fourth unit, two persons can sit. Space for placing the meat boxes are provided. We can put up to 120 boxes can be put. Refrigerator is provided up to 24 boxes. Now up to 2 hours, we can pack the meat and we can keep it. If we are keeping beyond 2 hours, then we can put it in the refrigerator. Platform weighing balance is given for weighing. Generator is provided. So now both options are there. If you want to connect it to the main power, then there's a main power option is there. If there is no main power, then you can use the generator power. When you are using the main power, if you're using some other's power connection, then we have given the power meter also. So that at the end of the day, whatever the power you have used, you can pay it to the from person who, from where you have taken. We have provided a first aid kit, slot for the display of the licenses, permits and certificates. All those things are provided here. Now again, to give more details of the accessories of the unit 4, we have a platform balance, steel boxes, standard weights, generator, electric switchboards, wall mounted fans, FM radio, okay, for entertainment, insect cutters, refrigerator, small scale refrigerator is there, whiteboard. In this whiteboard, we can write what is the meat you are having, what is the rate, price, okay, and also you can put the traceability information also. Here, what we are doing is taking the image. You can take the image and then from which animal it has come, whether it is Deccan in Nellore, you can show it. And then first aid kit is also there. Okay. Now appropriate lighting has been provided. What we have seen now, because generally meat cutting and packaging operation, it happens early in the morning. Especially in Hyderabad, it starts at around 4 o'clock. By 8 o'clock, everything will be finished. You will see nothing. That is why proper lighting is required. Now, what we have seen is this unit looks more elegant during the night. So, the proper lighting has been provided. As you can see here, we can very clearly see unit 1, 2, 3, 4, all the accessories required, movable, you know, wheeled structures, all everything is very clearly you can see here. And the operation, flow of operation, in the unit 1, in the lairage, resting of the animals before slaughter, provision for housing up to 10 animals, anti-mortem inspection. Now, anti-mortem inspection, what you can do is, you can have a link with the nearest veterinarian and you can give the charges as per the anti-mortem charges given in the slaughterhouse. Okay. Now, one option is either veterinarian can come and see. Okay. Otherwise, you can take the temperature, infrared thermal, IRT, temperature you can take. And also, you can make the video call and you can show the animal health condition to the veterinarian. So, nowadays, everything is going online. Classes are going online, whether it is school or everything. Now it is also time to go for anti-mortem, post-mortem inspection also online. So we have created a facility in such a way veterinarian can come and see. Otherwise, we can also do it online. Okay. In the unit 2, there are provision for electrical stunning, bleeding, collection of the blood, flaying, de-skinning, evisceration, removal of visceral organs, post-mortem inspection, washing of carcass, singeing of head and feet, halving of the carcass, and all these processes are done here. Here also postmortem inspection, you can take the image and you can send it, and then also veterinarian can come and see also. And then you need 3, carcass cutting and packaging, cutting of the carcass into cut up parts, deboning of carcass, cutting of the bones, cubing and mincing, provisions are given, washing of the meat and bone. For washing, we have provided the buckets wherein the meat can be washed, weighing and packaging, cutting of the head and feet into pieces and packaging. In the unit 4, retailing of the meat, okay, and byproducts in steel boxes, storing of the excess meat and byproducts in the refrigerator. And next, coming to the waste disposal. That is the most important, because pollution control board, whenever you are going for a slaughterhouse, before a slaughter starting, we have to take permission from the PCB, and after construction of your building also, you have to take the permission from the PCB. That is called consent for establishment. You have to take before establishment, consent for operation after establishment. Many of the places we have seen recently, one entrepreneur, he has done a slaughterhouse, and after construction, PCB visited and they told, no, you cannot do here, you have to shift it to the back side of your plot. So everything he has lost. So that is why what we have done is, we have provided the special waste treatment facility in this. Now, how we have done is, in the same report, that Pollution Control Board report 2017, which was released by the Central Pollution Control Board, they have given certain best available technology for the waste disposal, that is the BAT, they call it. Okay. So here the term BAT constitutes a moving target based on technological advancement and best practices, since developing societal values and advancing techniques may change what is currently regarded as reasonably achievable and best available. All the best available technological units, that is various treatment units adopted for the treatment of slaughterhouse, has been described below. Now they have given several options. This is a freely downloadable document, you can see, for different scales. So we have taken what suits us. Okay. So what we have taken is anaerobic process for decomposition of the organic and inorganic matter in the absence of molecular treatment. So here we have taken the anaerobic method for waste treatment. The major applications have been in the stabilization of the concentrated sludge, okay, produced from treatment of wastewater. Now, as you can see here, in anaerobic digestion process, organic material in the mixtures of primary settled and biological sludge is converted biologically under anaerobic conditions to variety of end products, including methane and carbon dioxide. The process is carried out in a reactor, what you call biomethanation plant, biogas plant, what you say, the same. Sludge introduced continuously and intermittently is retained in the reactor for varying periods of time. The stabilized sludge withdrawn continuously or intermittently from the reactor is reduced in organic and pathogen content is non-reproducible. The two types of commonly used anaerobic digesters are identified as standard rate and high rate. Okay, there are two types. So one takes 30 to 60 days, another takes around 15 days. So we have taken such a digester. It can be completed in around 15 days. This process will be over. Once you start, after 15 days, sludge will start coming out. That can be used as a very good organic manure. And methane also production will be there. That methane, whatever produced from this slaughterhouse, daily it can run 4 hours of whatever the household requirements for the gas, you know, LPG gas, just like that, whatever the gas stoves are there, you can run for 4 hours. Anaerobic digestion in the high rate reactors represents an attractive alternate for the wastewater. This is the PCB report only I'm reading. Okay. And now it says the second anaerobic digestion provides the COD and suspended solids involved while reducing the recoverable source of energy in the form of methane. It generates a low quantity of sludge and does not acquire aeration. Okay. Finally, okay, anaerobic bacteria can survive unfed for long periods of time, and an important feature for small slaughterhouses that operates just a few days a week or close down during the slow or holiday period. Sometimes what happens, continuous production, if you are establishing a large scale effluent treatment plant, there should be continuous operation. Otherwise, they will become, they will start emanating smell. That is why in these kinds of things, okay, so even if there is a gap also, they can run. Okay. Now, advantages here is recovery of the energy in the form of biogas. It reduces the pollution load and removes the suspended solids. Okay. So now we have done a lot of research, and then we have two options we have initially explored. One is whatever the solid waste GIT content was coming. Initially, we dewatered it. So dewatered, we went for a solid waste treatment, and to leading it to the production of the compost. But this option is also there. If someone wants, they can use it. So this can be used when you have separate sludge treatment plant nearby. Solid waste you will develop into compost. Whatever the liquid waste little bit comes, so that can be put into the sewage treatment plant available with the municipal bodies. If that sewage treatment plant option is not available, then you can go for the biogas plant. So these biogas plants, whatever the at the end of the day, once the work is over, we have provided the cans for the collection of the liquid waste. So all this liquid waste and whatever solid waste comes, GAT content, everything is it will be put at the end of the day. They will carry home, because this biogas plant has to be put near the house, because whatever the methane produced, it can be used for the gas stove purpose. So we can go on putting in this, and then after 15 days, it starts producing the methane. And every day it can be used up to for 4 hours. It can be used. Now, what is the process? Waste fed into the system. It will sink. Okay. In the second step, bacteria digest the organic waste in the tank and turn it into the biogas. Biogas is aggregated in the tank and stored in the low pressure. Okay. And then gas flows from the system to the kitchen via the pipe, and liquid fertilizer, which comes out of it, is a byproduct which can be used for as a fertilizer. This is the thing. Okay. Now, what are advantages of this PMART? Low cost, suitable for small scale operations, that is 10 animals. Mobility, it can be moved usually because of the wheels. Portability, if you want, wherever you want, you can shift it, you can usually move it. Requires little space, as I told, 4 feet by 16 feet is the only requirement. Only 2 manpower required. Less water per animal slaughtered. We have channeled it in such a way that only little water is used. Environment friendly, good hygiene features. Consumer satisfaction, durable, that is completely unit is made up of stainless steel 304. So it is a rust free material, and it is a food grade material, animal welfare compliant, comfort issues and training of the manpower is taken care. Now highlights of the unit is anti-mortem, post-mortem, environmental friendly, waste management and animal welfare issues. Okay. And now once the technology is provided, first we have submitted for the patenting. We have submitted the patent. After that, technology has been transferred to a private enterprise in Hyderabad, KSN Enterprises. Okay. Now fabrication unit established NRC on meet Hyderabad only with the help of the entrepreneur. After technology transfer, he has established a unit at NRC on meet. Good number of inquiries have been received. Now we are also approaching the central government to include it under the subsidy schemes. The unit the unit has been released. Now, as you can see here at NRC on meet, fabrication unit has been established. Usually what happens whenever a research institute develops a technology, generally they don't go into the field. So in order to avoid that, what we have done, we have commercialized the technology, we have gone to entrepreneur, we have established the fabrication unit, and in the down what you can see is a PMUD demonstration unit. This is the only small room what you require. Okay, so around 20 feet length and around 20 feet width and then around 20 feet length. That's what is required. A small room is required. So this is a small room. So whenever you want, you can visit it. So we established a small demonstration unit. We have initially established the fabrication unit. Now every Monday we do offline trainings in our institute. The charges for the offline training is 500 rupees per person. They can come here, they can stay, they can see the whole unit. Okay, they can feel it and they can go. And if they want to go, if they want to do slaughter training, then it comes around 1000 rupees. Now this is the director animal husbandry of Telangana. Now a lot of demand is coming. Every Monday we are doing trainings. Even we have started the online training also. Some people from Northeast they want now. For popularization, it has come in all the local newspapers of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. Okay, and then we are regularly organizing training program. So as some of the participants, you can see director animal husbandry of Telangana, and then director of SARP, that is Society for Elimination of Rural Poverty, and different entrepreneurs, meat handlers. There is a lot of demand is coming. A lot of bookings are booking for the trainings are happening. Good number of positive inquiries for purchase are also coming. Okay, so that is about our PMART unit. Thank you very much. So this is a very user friendly thing. We are also trying for different kinds of clearance from different places. If some people anyone wants, they can come for the training and they can purchase it also. Thank you very much. Now there are some questions in the chat box. Is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I will go to some of the questions which are there in the chat box. Okay. How is the infrared thermometer used in animals? It is just like what we use the humans. Wherever nowadays, because of corona, wherever you go, no, in the hand they check it. No, same way. You put it near the skin and you can record the temperature. It can be used for humans and animals. What are the significant difference between chowan and mutton? Oh. Okay, chowan is goat meat. Okay, and mutton is sheep meat. Difference is mainly in the fat content. Chowan is generally fat free, very little fat. Mutton will have the higher fat. That's called marbling. Marbling is intramuscular fat. Intramuscular fat, it's called marbling, is more in mutton than that of chowan. What about slaughter and packing training for new entrepreneurs? Our institute has a very good slaughterhouse for training. Even the regular operations, whatever the avatar is, that kind of training is also there. For the PMA training also, now we have made it open. Our turnkey product undertaken for Gram Panchayat Nagar Palika. Yeah, we can. Now we are already, we have MOU with around 6 municipalities we are providing. In the last week only, we signed the MOU with Karnataka Housing Board. They are establishing slaughter for Karnataka Sheep and Wool Development Corporation, KSWDCL. So now they are establishing a slaughterhouse in Sira in Tumkur district. So there we are providing a technical consultancy. We provide the technical inputs. How can you help to install this unit at our own Gram Panchayat? We can provide the drawing. Okay. And this unit, PMART for a Gram Panchayat, for God's sake, don't go for construction of the building. All those things, you know, it becomes a huge headache actually. And most of the places which is not used. So our small scale portable unit, what I have shown, this is very little investment, you can use it. How are the byproduct skin handled? Now skin earlier, nowadays, there are people who buy all these things. Earlier, there is a very good for skin. It used to go up to 200 to 300, 400 rupees also. Nowadays, there are not many takers. But however, some people are there who come and take the skin and other offal and byproducts also. Hide processing, now due to presence of the synthetic leather and all, nothing much. However, you can find out wherever it is available, you can sell it. So what we have done is we have provided the tank or can where the skin can be put, and then after at the end, it can be sold. So what is the cost of this unit? The basic cost of the unit is 8.5 lakh, 8 lakh 50,000 plus GST. GST is around 18%, that comes to around 10 lakh rupees. Now plus transportation, the whole unit including GST is 10 lakh, transportation cost is extra. Now cost and capacity of the meat mincer, up to 4 kg per hour you can do it. Now this in the within this 10 lakh, this cost of the mincer is also covered. How can you identify the chavan and mutton? So species identification NRC and meat is the only institute in India which is having NABL accredited meat species identification laboratory. Okay, we can do it. Now how it is differentiated, now it can be done based on the fat content only. Is it suitable for pig? We are now initially we started with sheep and goat, and this year we'll be coming up with the for the chicken and the pig also. So now we are already in the process, because lot of demand is coming from the northeastern region for the mobile pig slaughterhouse. So that is why we are going for it, and hopefully in this financial year we'll be doing for the pig also. So how can we apply for online training in PMart? Online, you can message me. I will message my number. You can send the message, and every Monday it will be there. We will send you the details. Okay. So you have to send your Aadhaar number and your name, and you have to, there is an account number. You have to send 500 rupees. Then most of the week it will be every Monday training will be there, and that time you can attend the trainings. Okay. So they are the some of the questions in the chat box. If any other questions are there, you can ask. Any questions?
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Any questions from the participants? He can raise his hand and ask the question.
So it is the last session. So people are tired, huh? They want to have dinner. Anyone involved, whether anyone is involved in the meat production activities in this group?
Most of our participants are they are academicians or researchers or students,
and okay.
Entrepreneurs are a few only.
Okay. Okay. If there are no questions, Dr. Girish, thank you so much.
So if there are no questions.
Hello.
The staff here is okay from our participants that you have given us. Sir, one second, please.
Hello.
Yes, Dr. Avinash.
Yeah, sir. We want to establish such type of model unit, slaughtering unit for goat in our gram panchayat, sir.
Okay.
What all cooperation we will get from you, and what funds will be required for that?
You are talking about the PMart. Are you talking about PMart?
Yeah.
Yeah, PMart. As I told, you require a very little space. Now the cost is around 10 lakh.
Space is not problem. Space is not problem, sir. Amount and what all technical guidance for slaughtering, training and all that.
Yeah, completely. Whomsoever is there, you can bring the people at NRC and meet. We'll provide the training. We have a very good training facility. And then if you want to purchase, you can directly approach us. We have the entrepreneur, and it will be manufactured under our complete control only, under our supervision. You can take the unit and you can establish it. After that, whomsoever the people they want to use it, we can come there and train also. Or they can come here and get the training also.
Okay, thank you. But we are having 10 gram panchayats who are interested in this.
Yes.
sir, please, please for 5 minutes.
Yeah, yeah.
Our 10 gram panchayats are interested to have hygienic meat.
Okay, where is it? Which district?
Atpadi, Sangli district.
Okay.
On from our side, we want training for the persons who are going to slaughter the animal.
Okay.
And the unit cost, so the which can be beared by the gram panchayat.
Yeah, yeah. As I told, the cost is 10 lakhs, and you can bring the people for training. Now we have made it available for the training also. Anytime you can bring the people and they can see here. And after that, yeah. You want to establish, you can purchase and you can install it, and we'll provide all the technical inputs, training, everything we'll provide.
Okay, sir. Thank you. We will contact you after speaking to all gram panchayats, sir.
Sure. And also somebody was asking for the bank loan in the chat box. The bank loan, actually, you have to have a DPR. For the DPR, for that purpose, we'll be providing. We have ready-made DPR available. In the banks, they provide the loan up to 90% they provide. And after that, for the subsidy purpose, they will send it to the NABARD. In the regarding the subsidy, you can go to Directorate of Animal Husbandry, Ministry of Animal Husbandry, Central Government website. There is an Entrepreneurship Development Program fund is there, EDP fund is there. So now, once in a year, they release. The recommendation for this purpose is provided by Director Animal Husbandry of each state. Now you will take the loan, you will buy the unit, and you will apply it, and then every year some amount is released, and the subsidy is provided on first come first serve basis. And there are some 25%, 33% is there, SCST 33%, general 25%. All that loan subsidy things you can ask in the bank. Now we have also written to the Central Ministry of Animal Husbandry also to include this unit under that. I think this comes under rural development. Definitely it will be included. I think you can ask any bank, and for that purpose, whatever the DPR is required, we will provide you.
So whether anybody else wants to ask any question? So this is our today's last session.
Somebody, Prasanna Chikkur Nagaraj, he raised the hand.
Please, Nagaraj sir, please ask.
Yes. Tell me. Please go ahead.
Sir, anything is being processed at CFTRI Mysore, Central Food and Training Research Institute, Mysore, in Karnataka.
Yes, no, I am also from Karnataka. CFTRI Mysore is under CSIR. It is a CSIR institute. Okay.
Yeah.
So there it works on all food products, including meat. There is a meat science department there.
Yeah.
In meat science department, I think there will be processing and training facility will be available. Okay. But our institute, we do not have any interaction with them.
So how we can assess the different species meat? How can we assess it in a field condition?
Field assessing for what purpose?
For any field conditions, if they bring with some adulteration or something, some problem. Okay, sir?
See, actually, our institute has a specialized laboratory for species identification of meat. Okay.
Yeah.
But there are visibly, you can see, we have some books and all, we can send you, there is no problem. You know, for example, red meat is red, bright red.
Yes, sir. At least, of course, the basic direct visibility I can assess the advanced books and all. So anything like for simple techniques to assess 3-4 variety of meat, like goat or this one in the form of consistency or something like that. I must be.
Sir, I have we have a detailed information about this. You kindly contact me separately. I will give you a separate presentation.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Anybody else who wants to talk to sir? He wants to ask this query. Dr. Mohammad Izhar sir wants to ask you, sir, is any permission required for the unit from government authorities?
No, for any slaughterhouse, for this also, first is local body, okay? Local body clearance, and then you have to take FSSAI certification. They easily happen, actually. And now more local bodies, if it is a city municipal authority, we have to take. If it is a rural area, then Gram Panchayat, that can be easily done. FSSAI certification, it can be easily done. And then now the main thing is the pollution control board. PCB only sees whether you are disposing your waste properly or not. Now in our unit, we have provided a facility in such a way that not even a single drop of the liquid waste goes out of it. That is why there is no problem. This is a small scale unit. Only FSSA clearance and local body certification, two things are sufficient. What is the organic meat in texture consistency and what is the market rate? Actually, organic meat, NRCN meat, the first time we have developed organic sheep in our institute. Actually, we have taken some land, we have converted the organic fodder first. And after that, we have reared the organic sheep, okay? And we took the certification for the organic sheep also. And slaughter is going on today also. Today and yesterday, tomorrow, organic sheep slaughter is going on. Meat quality is being analyzed. And now it will be same as the normal meat. And it will be free from any chemical residues, no treatment. Organically certified feed is provided, okay? And again, organic is a separate thing. There are lots of details are there. First requirement is landless animal rearing is not permitted. First, you should have a organic fodder plot. After converting organic plot, you have to go for the animal. First, you have to get the animal converted. Wherever the disease management conditions, if you can control the disease by management conditions, you should control. Otherwise, including vaccination is permitted. So wherever if an animal is suffering from certain treatment, you can provide the treatment and you can withdrawal period. Several things are there. If you want to show know more details, you have to go to NPOP, National Program for Organic Production. Okay, NPOP guidelines of APEDA, Agriculture and Processed Food Export Development Authority. Guidelines are there. You go through those guidelines. How to rear the complete organic sheep and everything is provided there.
Whether anybody else wants to ask? So it was really a wonderful session, and it was a great time to listen Dr. Girish Patil, sir.
So some people asked for mobile number and the mail ID. I have sent it, so they can contact anytime.
Okay. Yes, sir. I will share your contact with them, and email ID has already been provided to them. Your name, designation, name of the organization, and email address. I will provide them. I'll provide them your contact number too. So thank you very much, sir, for such a wonderful lecture and sparing your valuable time from your busy schedule. And even on a single call, you were ready to help us. You were ready to give lecture here. So thank you very much, sir. And henceforth, we'll take care that we'll invite you in advance. And definitely, I'm sure that you will also enthusiastically help us and cooperate us again by conducting few more lectures in upcoming training program. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much from organizer sides and from our institute.
Thanks for the opportunity. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.